Hey everyone, I'm here to do another review of, as I mentioned, if you saw my first long videos dealing with my record collection from the 80s, I had mentioned I have 8-tracks, which I originally had purchased when I first got my new stereo system back in 1979. And this was my first case that I got. It holds 24 8-tracks. I have a few of them in here, which I'll show in a second, because once I filled this one up, I got this bigger one, which I think it holds, I don't know, say around 50-ish. I took out the liner inside where it had the little the sleeves, like when you slide them in, so I can stick more in it. But anyways, as you can see, some of the stickers are some of the places I went to as a kid. You know, Royal Gorge, Pikes Peak, Mammoth Caves, in Arizona, the Meteor Crater, you know, Busch Gardens. I've been in Tampa and the one in Virginia. Let's see what else I got. Some stickers on here. I like, as a kid, whenever we traveled somewhere, picked up stickers, you know, Kings Island outside of Cincinnati. I was in Key West in the early 80s. Of course, Disney, and then near where I live now, but I originally was from Western PA, of course, SeaWorld. As you can see, I was a big Pitt Panther fan back in the 80s. Back when Jackie Sherrill, Dan Marino was the quarterback, and Hugh Green, defensive player that was up for, I mean, just the 80s, you know, I enjoyed that time. And then pretty much after Jackie Sherrill left, the Pitt program hasn't really been the same as it once used to be. I mean, they had their moments off and on, but now I live in Ohio. I liked Ohio State just because of Jim Tressel, because he was a Youngstown State coach back in the 90s, and when he went to Ohio State, I was more of a Tressel fan. But now that he's gone, don't really hate Ohio State, just was never a fan of Ohio State. So where I lived, you were either Ohio State, Penn State, Pitt, Panthers in the 80s, you know, because they were pretty good. And, you know, that rival between Pitt and Penn State was always there. But anyways, I want to show you real quickly the music I had from the late 70s into the 80s, when I bought 8-tracks instead of albums, and when they quit making them in the early 80s. So, as I mentioned, I have a bunch of AC/DC, For Those About to Rock, the Back in Black album, which is my favorite album. AC/DC was one of the groups that I wasn't really too fond of in the beginning, especially prior to Brian Johnson, when it was Scott that was the lead singer. I got this through, because when Back in Black made it big, of course, they brought out a lot of their older stuff. And it's all right. Don't say I hate them. It's just a different style of the 70s. And like I said, I was more into the 80s music. But as I got older, I really, 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 this Back in Black album was probably my number one album, or at least top five. As you can see, I'm a big Pat Benatar fan. In the Heat of the Night, really liked her rocking style of music when she first came out. In the Heat of the Moment, Crimes of Passion. I liked her earlier stuff. It was more rockish, you can say, Precious Times. Then I liked Blondie. I know she's kind of like new wave-ish, but I just like that. It kind of reminds me of the Cars a little bit. I mean, I just liked her. Some of her early stuff again too. I really got into her. Yeah, Eat to the Beat. That was kind of Parallel Lines. Some Plastic Letters. Then as I got some of the albums, yeah, I just liked her stuff. And I also experimented like with heavy metal. Black Sabbath, which, you know, I only have one. I know Ozzy came from that group at one time, but I think this was after Ozzy. I know there must have been a song I liked, and then I got it, and yeah, it wasn't for me. Blues Brothers. Of course, you have to like the Blues Brothers because of the movie, the soundtrack, Belushi and Dan Aykroyd. There was a couple hits they had on the radio that, you know, Rubber Biscuit, whatever songs that were on here that were a catchy radio. Let's see. Give Me Some Lovin' was a remake. I mean, songs from the movie, Jailhouse Rock. So, anyways, Yeah, it's jazzy, bluesy. It's like, you know, it's different. And there was, like I said, those catchy radio songs. Blue Oyster Cult. You know, I like some of their style. Let me see. I know some of the more popular, that the Godzilla song and some other ones that had a lot of radio play and still do. Of course, I love the first two Boston albums. They pretty much sound the same, but that just, it was, you know, some great, great tunes. Back to back, then I can't believe it took them 10 years, plus years, to get out the third album. But anyways, Jackson Browne, Hold Out. They had a popular song on here that I liked, I think from MTV. Yeah, he's all right. I mean, there again, it kind of reminds me of the 70s style music. And I got this one just because I think I liked the other song, and that was it. And as I mentioned, I got four Cars. Love them. You know, this is their first album, The Cars. Trying to think of some songs. My Best Friend Girl, love that song. Just What I Needed, Good Times Roll. Bye Bye, love that. I don't know if that was a radio song, but I like that song. Of course, the next one, this was my, as one of my VRs contests. I just stuck that on there because the album cover is pretty hot. And then Panorama. And Shake It Up, that was a pretty popular tune. Now Cheat Trick. I guess I got one of their albums and eventually started buying albums. I got the High and Dry, Def Leppard. Of course, that was prior to Hysteria and Pyromania. I think I got Pyromania, and then of course got this album because this is 81. And Pyromania was 83. Oh, how can you not like Devo? Whip It. Of course, that's their all-time favorite song. So had to get that one. Eagles, of course, this is like the time out. You know, one of the long, most selling albums, or at least in the top whatever 100 songs or selling albums for the longest time. It had some good tunes. It was, let me see, Long Run, let's see. You know, it was all right. I mean, again, I was more into harder rock, but, you know, there were some nice tunes. The Electric Light Orchestra, I guess, I don't know. It was kind of like, kind of some catchy tunes. I know it's like the late 70s, kind of roller skating rink tunes where if you're with your friends or if you had a girlfriend at the time, you would slow dance to some of these tunes or do some little bit of a disco type of era. But, you know, I like a couple of their songs. That was about it. Excellent. Late 70s. And of course, Fleetwood Mac. Rumors was their probably number one album. You know, you see, come up, you know, Foreigner, as you can see here, I got three of their albums. Double Vision. This was, had some great Hot Blooded. Double Vision. Great tunes on that album. Foreigner 4 was probably one of the last 8 tracks I bought. I remember getting this one, I think the summer before my senior year. Some great, I don't know, tunes that were, you know, if you were dating, I'm trying to find. Jukebox Hero was a popular song. Urgent. But what, like I said, one thing I hate about 8 tracks, they always like to split up a song or two. And of course, this was The Head Games, pretty good album. Dirty White Boy, Head Games. Genesis, I got this one. Wasn't really into, I mean, there was one song, I guess. This is, you know, Phil Collins before he went solo. You know, I got it. It's okay. Wasn't really a fan of them. So the Go-Go's, like I said, just because of the girls. And they have some catchy tunes, you know. This was a good selling album. Our Lips Are Sealed. We got the Beat. Trying to think what else. It was a catchy tune. Sammy Hagar. You gotta love Sammy. I don't know. Which one's this album? Danny Hampton, yeah. Of course, the Jay Giles Band. They had some catchy tunes. I mean, I played drums in high school in the band, marching band. So they had some catchy tunes. It was one of those things that, you know, they were rockish, jazzy, you know, bluesy. But of course, everybody had, you know, the centerfold song and the freeze frame, catchy radio tunes. Of course, Love Stinks was a catchy tune. Johnny Iris, as I mentioned, love this guy. Some great tunes on here. Sweet Merrily, Love Is Like a Rock. You know, songs that they still keep playing as a classic rock. Here's Joan Jett and the Blackhearts. I love rock and roll. That was a catchy tune. That lasted a good couple of years during our high school days. Put a dime in a jukebox, baby. Yeah, I don't know why I just did that. But Elton John, you know, Elton John is a great singer. I only have one album of his. I think this was one of the albums. This one, another one I was sure related to, my mom got me for Christmas when I got my stereo system. It was my first two, and it's like, yeah, it's just not my... I mean, you know, he had some good songs, but it wasn't my cup of tea. And as you can see, I got a couple Journey, their older albums, Departure and Escape, you know. Escape was a good album. I think this one has the Who's Crying Now, Open Arms, you know, good dating tunes. Kansas, there again, late 70s, the style of music, a lot of keyboard, synthesizer tunes. This is Point of No Return, probably one of their best albums. Couple of Dust in the Wind. The Kiss, I only got one 8-track from Kiss, Love Gun. I think this is another one my mom got me for one of our first couple albums. This album probably wasn't the best album to pick to get into Kiss. But there again, the 80s with MTV, you know, I got, as you saw from my previous video, Led Zeppelin, of course, is, again, I wasn't really a Led Zeppelin fanatic. I mean, of course, Stairway to Heaven is a song that, you know, as a 40-plus-year-old guy, you appreciate. But a lot of the songs just wasn't my cup of tea, so I never really got into Led Zeppelin. There again, late 70s, so I was more into 80s, new wave-ish rock, hair band in the late 80s. So, Little River Band, I don't remember why, probably a song on MTV. This was the mid-70s. There must be a song on here. Let's see if I can find it. I remember them, but I, for some reason, got a couple of their albums. First Underwire. Yeah. Now, the group that I mentioned, I got a couple of their albums. This is their first one, Loverboy. I'm trying to think of some song. The Kids Are Hot Tonight, that was a great tune. Yeah. And then Get Lucky was a great, great album. I'm trying to think of some songs from that. Working for the Weekend is always a top hit. And then, like I said, this is one my mom got me, Barry Manilow. I think she got it because she liked the song. I mean, yeah, he's a good singer and all, but just, you know, that's just a different generation. You know, he was a, you know, I don't know. It is what it is. Molly Hatchet with some Southern rock. You know, I like some Southern rock, and I know a lot of kids in my school bus were playing this tune. And it, like I said, I got it because everybody's had it, but I didn't really listen to them much. Like I said, don't hate them, just not my cup of tea. Nazareth, The Hair of the Dog. I like this one because of the song. Let's see if I can find it. I think one was Cocaine, you know. There was another one on here, I think. It was a popular song. Cocaine, of course, a lot of groups. I think Nazareth was the original. Now here's The Hair of the Dog album. This was pretty popular back in the day. Love Hurts, that's another, you know, popular song that they had. So between those couple songs, you know, they're good. But Ted Nugent, you know, you gotta love Ted. Tenacity. Ozzy, you know, the first two albums, Blizzard of Oz with Crazy Train. That was a great, great tune. Diary of a Madman. And then eventually, I think that at this point, I bought it, started buying albums. Alan Parsons Project, do not remember why. I think the song, The Queen of Hearts, I think it was called. Let's see if I can find it on here. I don't know. Don't remember. Yeah. Tom Petty Heartbreaker had, you know, his Torpedoes. No, this is the Hard Promises. But that first album was really great. I don't know why I never got that one, but you know, he was all right. You know, it wasn't one of those groups that you love him or hate him. He's right there in the middle. Pink Floyd was an album too that you had to grow on. I mean, it was a long album. You know, from the movie, it had some classic tunes that, you know, they're a classic group that as older I got, the more I kind of respect and enjoy more. Queen, The Game, great album, a lot of great songs on here. Another one, Bites of Dust, was a great radio tune. Of course, the other songs from our previous albums, We Are the Champion, was played constantly. Remember Junior High, you know, and what was it, the two songs together, We'll Rock You. So between those two songs, it was always, every time we had a radio in our cafeteria, and when that tune came on, everybody was banging the table, stomping the floor. I think eventually they got rid of the radio, but anyways, that was my junior high days when they got REO Speedwagon. Like I said, I bought this one. Why, I can't remember what song is on this one. Of course, there are other albums that I showed from a previous video. Rock 80, which is one of those things you know, let's see what some of the groups are on this one. Get a lot of the new wave. Gary Numan, The Knack. Well, there's Pat Benatar. There's Joe Jackson. Anyways, kind of like I said, it was a rock 80 variety of groups that was popular in 1980. Of course, Rolling Stone. They're the one of those groups. There's some great songs they had during their 60s and 70s, and this was like one of their 80s. Tattoo You, Start Me Up was a catchy song, still is. A lot of, wasn't a fanatic of theirs, but I liked them. Of course, I really liked Rush. Exit Stage Left. Love the YYZ drum solo by Pert. He was probably my favorite drummer just because, I wasn't really a great drummer, but I just liked his style playing. Of course, Permanent Waves was a great album. Spirit of Radio, Jacob's Ladder. Back then, they didn't have too many songs. They had long songs. Michael Stanley Band, of course, this was a great album. Heartland, had some good MTV radio play. Of course, they're from, when I lived in Pennsylvania, they lived near Cleveland area. So, and then, as I mentioned, when I filled up this case, here's the leftovers. Billy Squire, Don't Say No. That was a good album. That was probably his number one album. That he, In the Dark. Don't Say No. This one doesn't have the Stroke. Oh, yeah, the Stroke song. So, I mean, that was his, Of course, I liked the Styx. Again, kind of like Kansas. It was just that era of, that people liked and you kind of liked, but you had to get that album just because everybody else had it. Supertramp, there again, they had the Breakfast in America. That one catchy tune. See, Breakfast in America, was that it? I'm trying to see if anything else jumps at me. Yeah, I mean, it was like I said, I don't think they're from Australia, maybe. They're kind of like Men at Work. Anyways, and then, of course, Van Halen, Fair Warnings, which I think was their third or fourth album. Because, of course, they had Van Halen 1, Van Halen 2, and it might have been their Women and Children first. I can't remember if that was third or fourth. But anyways, this was when, 19, what year is this? Usually it gives you the copyright date, 81. So, I think this was definitely, of course, 1984 was their all-time popular MTV / radio. But anyways, that's it. That's my 8 tracks that I first bought before starting buying albums. I don't know if I will show you all my CDs that I've collected. A lot of them were mostly greatest hits of groups that I liked. So, those are my collections from the late 70s into the mid-80s. So, enjoy. Have a great day. I've been homesick the last 2 days. Haven't done much. My wife came up with these other babies and going, and now they all left. My wife running around taking the kids to basketball practice, boys, guys, girl scouts. So I had some quiet time. And there, of course, is our lazy cat, which I'm not a cat lover. Don't hate cats. Love my dogs that we had when they, but my daughter, we had a dog for my son when he passed away. So we had to get a cat for my daughter. Be fair. Anyways, have a great one. Bye.